Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today in this video we will discuss a question related to lithium toxicity. In the previous video we have studied about what are the clinical features of lithium toxicity or what are the measures that we should take to prevent the lithium toxicity. So this question we will see how it connects with that particular topic that we have studied. I will start with the question. A client has been on lithium carbonate therapy for 7 days. Which of the following findings would be most important to report to the healthcare provider? I will reword the question. A client, she has been or he has been taking lithium carbonate for the past 7 days. She started that therapy. And once she is on that therapy, when the nurse will see which symptom, she should inform to the healthcare provider. Or out of the symptoms that we'll see in this client, which will be most important to inform to the healthcare provider to prevent further complications. When we study lithium toxicity, we know that certain late and early symptoms of lithium toxicity. If we will see such symptoms, we should immediately inform to the healthcare provider and took interventions. Otherwise, it might be lead to complications because lithium toxicity is a life-threatening complications. Because it will show some neurological problems also if you will not take appropriate treatment at the initial stage. So out of these four options, which is most important or which one be the unexpected complication or the problem related to this lithium carbonate therapy? We'll see. Option 1, diarrhea, vomiting and mild tremor. Option 2, dry mouth and mild thirst. Option 4, hyperactivity and auditory hallucination. Option 4, lithium level of 1.3 milliequivalent per liter. What do you think? Which could be the right answer? If you might have watched the previous video of lithium toxicity or if you have an idea about lithium carbonate therapy, right now you might got the correct answer. We'll see from the down. A lithium level of 1.3 milliequivalent liter. What we studied? The normal range of lithium is very narrow and that is 0.6 to 1.2 milliequivalent per liter. But when a client is on lithium carbonate therapy, the level, it might be between 1 and 1.5 milliequivalent per liter. So it will exceed more than 1.5 milliequivalent per liter, that time immediately we should inform to the healthcare provider because the client is going to lithium toxicity. Is that clear? So here it says 1.3 milliequivalent liter. So it is an unexpected finding. We can eliminate option 4. Now option 3, hyperactivity and auditory hallucination. What do you think? We know that the client who is on lithium therapy is diagnosed with a bipolar mania or mania. So this hyperactivity and auditory hallucinations are the normal or the common clinical features that we already expected or that is already there in the client before starting the lithium carbonate therapy. And we know that the lithium therapy or lithium carbonate therapy will take up to 3 weeks to show its effectiveness on the client's body. Or the therapeutic effect will start after 3 weeks of initiation of therapy. So now it is only 7 days. So definitely the client might have the symptom of his disease in his body. That is an expected finding. So no need to inform to the healthcare provider. This is not important. This need treatment and the client already started treatment. But this is not something problematic related to lithium carbonate therapy. So we can eliminate option 3 and option 4. Now we have only 2 options. We'll see what is option 2. Dry mouth and mild thirst. What do you think? What is the meaning of that? We know that dry mouth and mild thirst are some of the expected side effects of a lithium carbonate therapy. And that usually resolve spontaneously. So when we start lithium carbonate therapy in a client, the nurse will instruct the client, you might have experienced a side effect of lithium carbonate therapy as dry mouth or mild thirst. That is an expected thing. So that is also something most important finding that the nurse should inform to the healthcare provider. So now we have eliminate option 2, 3 and 4. So what could be the answer? Definitely 1, because that is only the pending option. Why 1 is our answer? Why diarrhea, vomiting and mild tremor are the most important finding that should inform to the healthcare provider? Because that is the earliest findings of lithium toxicity. We studied that, the acute symptoms of lithium toxicity, gastrointestinal disturbance. When we see such gastrointestinal disturbance in a client who is taking lithium carbonate therapy, we should suspect lithium toxicity and we should take immediate action and inform to the healthcare provider to prevent further complications. Is that clear? So, and we know if we will not treat it, it will go to further neurological problems, confusion, agitation and all. So this is a warning, or this is an earliest sign that is very important. So out of this 4 option, option 1 is our answer, or option 1 is the finding which is most important to inform to the healthcare provider, because it is the earliest sign of lithium toxicity. Hope it's clear to you. We will come with some other questions of mental health nursing on the coming videos. Bye for now and all the best.